Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. We see that still people are joining. We wait 1 minute before we start. Okay, let's get started. Welcome everyone to our webinar about bio-based adhesives for timber construction by Henkel Adhesive Technologies. My name is Adrian Brandt. I'm a chemist by background. I'm working with Henkel for 10 years and currently I'm leading our bio-renewable materials team. This is an R&D group. And our mission is to replace all fossil raw materials by renewable carbon-based materials. And this can be from biomass, this can be from waste, or even from CO2, carbon dioxide. Welcome everybody online to that webinar. I'm very excited to have many different people with different backgrounds here, architects, engineering companies, developers and anybody else who's interested in the field. Together with me here in the room in Düsseldorf, we are four people. So we have Christina Bauer from marketing supporting us in the background. Then we have our guest, Markus Steppler. Warm welcome to you from Derix Group. Markus will share later on his view on sustainable timber construction and also the latest project at Derix. Then we have Olga Golgor. She's leading our European sales team in the engineered wood business at Henkel Adhesive Technologies. So how does it work today? We have 45 minutes overall. And in the first part, we'll have Olga sharing her view and her passion about our latest eco adhesives in the field, sustainable timber construction. In the second part, we will have Markus, Managing Director at Derix, sharing his view about sustainable adhesives and timber constructions and also the latest projects at Derix. And after that, we have time for Q&A session. Very important for the online people, please use the chat function to type in your questions. You can do it right now and during the session. Hopefully we have enough time to tackle all of your questions. If not, we might come back to you later to follow up. Yeah, with that, I would like to hand over to you, Olga. The stage is yours. Please tell us about the Henkel eco adhesives.
Thanks a lot for the introduction, Adrian. Maybe let me first share a few words about myself. For almost 5 years, engineered wood has been now my focus, first in marketing and since 2022 in the role as head of sales for Europe. And I'm an industrial engineer from my background and for a long time already fascinated how actually powerful structural adhesives can be when used with natural materials and engineering. Now, we've seen engineered wood becoming more and more popular over the last few years, expanding from Europe to other regions. And therefore, I thought it would be actually great to show some amazing buildings in Europe and the architects behind them. And just to mention, in all these projects, our adhesives were used to make the mass timber elements. Let us start with the Cradle. It's a very impressive, innovative timber hybrid office in Düsseldorf, designed by HPP architects, and the CLT elements were actually built by Derek's company. So Markus might also mention that in his part. The second example is Zilla Seasons. It's a 5-star mass timber hotel in Austria, designed by Italian architect Matteo Thun, and CLT was manufactured by the company Binderholz. I myself had a pleasure to stay there very nice, and can only recommend you, if you have a chance, to go there to spend a couple of relaxing days. And last but not least, Bjerkstedt Financial Park in Stavanger, Norway, designed by Helen and Hart and Saha, and manufactured by Stora Enso and Møhlven. Now, these impressive buildings show why we at Henkel are so excited about timber construction, and we are actually continuously investing in new adhesives for these projects, and also created this webinar to promote our new bio-based adhesive for load-bearing engineered wood elements. A few words about us, Henkel Engineered Woods. So for more than two decades, Henkel is pioneering the use of Loctite polyurethane adhesives in engineered wood, especially in the cross-laminated timber market. But we do also supply multiple other applications and customers, such as finger-jointed timber, glulam, or I-joist. And we all know why wood construction and engineered wood products like CLT or glulam are on the rise. It's mainly because mass timber helps tackling challenges in the construction industry, which are first, rising building costs, and second, stricter environmental regulations. And here are just two numbers for you to keep in mind. So first, timber buildings produce around 70% less CO2 emissions compared to concrete and steel buildings. And as a second number to be aware of, they reduce construction time by over 85% compared to typical concrete constructions. Now, mass timber can only be made industrially by using certified adhesives that turn timber boards into construction products. And as a rule of thumb, we are seeing that there is about 4 kg of adhesive in 1 cubic meter of CLT, or cross-laminated timber. And even though adhesives make up less than 1% of the total weight of the element, switching to bio-based product significantly reduces CO2 emissions and increases the use of circular materials in construction. Now, to give you a tangible number, what does it mean? A bio-based adhesive for timber construction reduces CO2 by 8 kg in 1 cubic meter of CLT, which refers to about 10% reduction. And also just to visualize how much 8 kg of CO2 emissions is, it corresponds to roughly 60 kilometers driven in an average small car. Now let me explain how our bio-based adhesives are made. So what we see here is how chemistry works today. Fossil resources are used to create basic chemical products and to provide the energy needed for these processes. And both raw materials and process energy contribute to the product's carbon footprint. And to achieve a true circular economy, we need to stop using fossil resources and avoid emitting additional CO2. For process energy, this can be done relatively easy by using renewable energy sources like solar, wind, and hydropower. Many chemical companies have plans to reach climate neutrality for their energy emissions. And Henkel, for example, aims for 2030, and our plant where we produce our wood adhesives is already now climate neutral. Now, if you look on the other side for the raw materials, it is more challenging, and we need to use renewable raw materials instead of fossil ones, known as renewable carbon. And this can come from three different sources: biomass, recycling processes, and carbon capture. And this is much harder to do, and currently the chemical industry only gets about 12% of its materials from these sources. So overall, using biomass is currently the most viable way to replace fossil fuels with renewable carbon in adhesives. And biomass can come directly from plants like corns and soybeans, from agricultural or bio-waste, such as used plants and fats. And we do believe that in future, all three sources will be important. And by 2030, renewable carbon will have largely replaced fossil fuels. Now, what does this look like in more detail with biomass? So there are two approaches of how to use biomass for renewable carbon adhesives. First, to have direct bio-based materials using new molecules for new products. And second, mass balance approach using existing infrastructure and chemical value chains based on bio-based or circular feedstock. And this is also what you see here on this slide. At the start of the production chain, both fossil resources and renewable biomass are being used. And these raw materials go through the complex and interconnected production chain in the chemical industry. And as a result, if there is a portion of bio-based materials at the beginning, there will be a portion of bio-based materials at the end attributed to a final product. This approach has been applied in energy companies for years now, and they use both fossil and renewable energy sources to generate electricity, feed it into the power grid, and then sell either renewable or fossil-based energy at the end. For the customers, the picture is actually like that. So some are paying for the green electricity from renewable sources, but the electricity that actually arrives at their home will be mixed with electricity from other sources, such as oil, gas, or nuclear. And same principle applies also to mass balance approach. And to sum up, the mass balance approach accelerates the transition towards fossil-free circular value chains by allowing us to use existing assets and exact tracking of renewable carbon. Our new product line, Loctite HB S ECO, extends the well-known Loctite HB S line to bio-based options. And these adhesives use 63% biocircular feedstock, reducing CO2 emissions by 66% compared to fossil-based version. And there are also ISSS Plus certified, ensuring sustainable and traceable supply chains. And also, of course, very important to mention that the performance and the reliability of the adhesive remain unchanged, but with a much smaller carbon footprint. And in addition, HBS Eco adhesives are also cradle-to-cradle material health gold certified, and they have zero VOC or no formaldehyde emissions. Now, last but not least, the beauty of bio-based HBS Eco is that even though the raw materials basis is bio-based rather than petrol-based, the resulting adhesive is chemically 100% identical with its fossil-based counterpart. And that means for our customers, engineered wood producers, that switching to bio-based adhesives require no changes to existing production equipment, neither additional certification. Let me summarize what I just was telling about. So first, in the future, we believe that the chemical industry needs to switch to renewable carbon sources to foster circularity. And right now, renewable carbon sources are mostly linked to the mass balance approach. Loctite HBS Ecoline is the first of its kind certified bio-based adhesive for mass timber production. And with that, it enables an immediate step towards greater sustainability with no compromise in performance and no extra costs for certification or adaptation of manufacturing equipment. Therefore, we do believe that the future of sustainable timber construction is actually the future of HBS Eco. Thank you very much for your attention, and back over to you, Adrian.
Thank you very much, Olga, for your presentation and all the insights. For me, it's really interesting to see that we as Henkel go that way to even fossil-free adhesives. Hopefully, we can claim that in the future, so to achieve the 100% and fossil-free. I guess this is a real revolution, not only for Henkel to establish all this, but also for the world and the industry, especially the chemical industry, to switch from fossil to renewable carbon. This is a massive change, and you can compare it with the energy revolution to renewable energy or the mobility revolution to electric vehicles. This is a major shift in society. And this requires, of course, cooperation between suppliers and our customers, and really happy to go that way also with Derix. And that's the bridge to the next topic. The next topic is Derix. We have here Markus Steppler. Again, warm welcome. Markus, you also have sales experience, but recently you got announced as managing director at Derix. And you introduce your projects to us in a minute. I know at least one. That's the cradle building in Düsseldorf. It's close to our facility here in Düsseldorf, in the Harbor District. and it looks very exciting. It's already an award-winning building. We are talking really about eye-catching buildings. Very much looking forward to get your view on the topic. Please, stage is yours.
Yes, thank you very much, Olga, and thank you very much, Adrian, for the introduction. Good morning, everyone. My name is Markus Steppler, and let me first introduce to you the Derix Group, what we are doing and why we are doing this. First, we are a leading manufacturer of mass timber elements. We are producing as well glulam, glued laminated timber, and CLT, which is called XLAM in our house. And we are located in the western part of Germany with three production sites, and we are employing about 300 people here. Our base material or our focus is on producing the elements like CLT, as you see here in our modern factory in Westerkappeln, close to Osnabrück, and also glulam. And we are not only a producer, we are also building with these elements. And let me show you some projects which are on which we are working this year, that you have an image of our works. The special idea on all of these projects which you see here in the slide is that they are already they already have the idea of being remounted after their end of life, so they have a circular mind already in these all these projects. You see on the bottom right, you see the cradle, which is finished already, and some of the others in the Netherlands and also in Germany are finished, and all are designed in a circular approach. Well, what makes us special as a company? Our idea is that we want to be the most sustainable and the most circular thinking producing company of timber elements. 3 years ago, we decided that we implement a general take-back guarantee for all our elements, which means that we are taking back the elements after the end of life of the building. The idea is then to add a so-called technical cycle of our products, additional to the biological cycle, which is the forest and the growing wood on the left side. So we add the technical side, the technical circle on the right side, that our idea is to have an unlimited use of wood by taking back and reusing our elements. And then you can imagine that it's very important which material is inside our products. And this is also one reason why we chose to generally switch over to bio-based glue, as the HB S ECO in this case. I want to introduce one special project, which was the initial project for our take-back guarantee. It was 8 years ago when we built the Circle building in Amsterdam, and the owner of the building asked us, can you take back the elements after the end of life? And we were thinking about, what does it mean? We're building a building which is lasting 50, 80, 100 years or longer, but okay, let's underwrite this take-back idea. And so this was the first building which had an idea of being remounted and of taking back all the elements. You can see it here in the picture, which was taken during the construction on the construction site, that the elements are connected in a way that you can rebuild them again after the end of life. So it is a design which was chosen by the architects and designers, that the building can be easily being remounted, that we have many standard elements with a loose connection. So, and what is the reality? I got a call on the beginning of this year by the owner of the building, and he said, well, 8 years ago you built a building and you underwrote the take back guarantee. Now it's time, we have a new investor on site and we are rebuilding the building. Are you taking back the elements? Oh, okay. It was not so long lasting as we thought, but I must say that's reality. We are already in the circular economy. We are already in a state that buildings are not lasting like 100 or 200 years. Many buildings start being remounted after 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. So the reality has already overtaken us, and we're now in the take back of this building, and we are rebuilding indeed this building with 60% of the elements on another place. So it is important which material we have. This is important which glue you take, and then you have a material which can be easily being remounted in new buildings. Yeah, okay, that was my short introduction of what we are doing and why we are doing this, and thank you for listening at this point. Adrian.
Thank you very much, Markus, for your insights. So what I found personally very striking is that take back commitment topic. This is and was new for me. Very interesting to deconstruct buildings and reuse parts of it for next construction projects. I hope that flies, that is super interesting and truly pioneering concept in the industry. All of that triggers some questions we have at Henkel. And let me ask one to you, Markus. Since when is Derix using polyurethane adhesives from Henkel, and why?
Well, with the installation of our new production line of CLT, that was in the year 2019, we chose to take Henkel and as a partner for our PU adhesives, and since then we have Henkel as a very reliable and also very innovative partner, I must say.
Well, that's good to hear. What was your driver to fully switch to a bio-based, fossil-reduced circular adhesive from Henkel?
Well, as I said, we are focusing very highly on high standards in case of sustainability and circularity. So with the idea of taking back our products, we have a very high focus on what is inside our materials. We are also cooperating with a material passport, with material banks, and the more sustainable your product is, the more worth it will be in the future also. If you take it back, it has money for it, and it's better to have a sustainable product. And so even the glue is very important for us, and for us it was no question at all when Henkel said we have a new bio-based glue to add it to our factory for every project.
Yeah, you said it, or we said it, or I said it, that the glue can be a small part in the whole building. But what I also personally find very interesting is this whole shift from fossil to a true circular economy and also to renewable carbon means also a shift for all plastics, not only adhesives, really for all plastics that are also used in construction. So we are really in front of that revolution, hopefully make progress. But what is the first feedback and experience from the market with the new concept and the bio-based adhesive, Markus?
Well, we had really overwhelming feedback from architects, designers, and also building owners. And it fits perfectly in our idea and in our future ideas. We do not want to make it only for our own. We also want to be, engage also other companies, also along our whole supply chain, to change their mind, to think about the future, to think about sustainability, to think about circularity. And for us, it's very important to improve also our EPD and our carbon emissions. So it was no question for us to switch to this glue. Absolutely.
Thank you, Markus. Last question from my side. Coming back to the take back commitment. I mean, of course, also the glue is part of the timber modules. And what role does the glue play in that take back commitment?
Well, let me switch to 20 years in the future, for example. When we are building a building today and we will take it back in 20 years, people will ask, what are you taking back? What is this kind of material? Where does it come from? And if you then can say, well, we have wood in it and we have some glue in it, and this glue is bio-based, this glue has lower carbon emissions, this glue has a cradle-to-cradle certificate, people will say, okay, let's use it again. But if you take materials which are not designed this way, maybe people in the future will ask, well, this is not what we were thinking of to use it again. So I think the positive impact of this bio-based glue will be very high in the future.
Good to hear that, Markus. Thank you. So now let's move into the general Q&A session with the audience. So feel free to enter your questions into the chat. A few are already there. Let me start with the first one. There's a question for the obligation to take back the elements is a major commitment. You mentioned timeframes of 7 to 20 years. What maximum time frame do you expect?
Well, Andreas, this is a difficult question, I must say. First of all, our idea is to implement today this take back obligation, that people are today building buildings which are remountable. Because if you don't give this guarantee today, people don't think about remountable buildings in the future. So it's very important to make it today that buildings are designed this way. And we think the first buildings will be from, for example, logistic buildings with big timber frames on top, on the roof, or retail buildings. These buildings are designed for maximum 20 to 25 years. This will be the first one to rebuild and take back. And what the other types of buildings are doing in the future, I cannot say clearly, but I must say the parts which we are building with the timber and the glue, I think they will last 100 years or longer. This is our experience. So we have no problem with our building elements for taking the bed. What is unclear still now is how to prove that they can be rebuilt. So we have no regulations on this. This is quite difficult at the moment, but we still trust in politics that they will install a system and give us introductions how to use reused products in the future.
Thank you, Markus. There is another question to you. When you switch to the Eco Glue, maybe one before you answer one comment. It's unfortunately not 100% to be fair and transparent. So we are talking about 60 to 70% renewable carbon content. But of course, we are also developing plans to get to 100% fossil free and 100% circular and renewable carbon materials. But yeah, when did you switch, Markus?
When did we switch?
Yeah,
it was the first January of this year. And we were first thinking about, are we switching project-wise and offering this as an add-on? But that was no question for us. So we switched for the total production line, and we switched the glue generally for all the projects.
So that's why maybe we can even add, so in fact, Derix switched 100% to the Eco Glue. Maybe we can interpret that as such.
Yeah, that's right. So our... our fossil line is replaced 100% by the Eco Glue, but the Eco Glue is not 100% renewable carbon based.
Right.
Correct. Thanks a lot for sharing. My question to Derix. It's regarding take back guarantee again. So that's striking. What is the minimum share of remounted material you need to resell to a new project? And so does it make sense financially for you? 50% plus, question mark?
Well, we are analyzing the projects we are building at the moment. And our analysis today is that we will be able to reuse elements for 50 to 60% of the elements can be reused. 40 to 50% usually go into the cascade. So they go into the next products. And but for the really reuse, we are thinking about 50 to 60% at the moment. Did I get the whole question, Adrian? I don't know if I have got the second part.
What is the minimum share of remounted material was one part, and if it makes financial sense.
Financial sense, yes. That's the big question. And for this, you have to ask yourself, will material be more worth in the future or less? And when we were talking about generally taking back elements, this was one of our main questions. And all of us in our company said, we are thinking that material will be more worth in the future. So let's take it back. And this is the idea behind this. We believe that the material will be more worth. Of course, you have to take into account the costs for taking back and to refurbish it. But the idea is that we will sell then used products for a slightly less price than new products. This should be the goal for us. At the moment, we are still talking about pilot projects, like the circle, which I showed you before. But I think in 15 years, we are calculating with a constant taking back of the material.
Thank you, Markus. What is the shelf life of the bioadhesive?
Yeah, here that's a simple answer. So the shelf life is exactly the same as for our HBS product, which is up to 12 months, could be even extended a couple of more months. So it's exactly the same. There's no impact, let's say, no negative impact on the shelf life.
Yeah, and to add from my side, so we also introduced the mass balance concept, a little bit similar like the eco power concept in Germany. And with that, you have identical quality. So you can basically today create exactly the same materials from renewable carbon sources, waste, biomass, and even CO2 carbon dioxide from industrial point sources or direct air capture. And you have the same identical properties. You could do the same for plastics. For any plastic, 90% of what mankind is creating on the planet in chemistry can be replaced by that. And we are talking about there will be never a compromise in performance, minimum the same or better. So that's the approach. And of course, at the same time, increasing renewable carbon content, decreasing fossil content. And there is a question by to Henkel. How are you working with the delamination in case of fire?
Yeah, thanks, Daniel. So, I mean, of course, fire performance, fire-resistant adhesives, it's certainly also a topic, maybe not necessarily linked to bio, but certainly worthwhile for an extra webinar, which we might actually also do in the course of this year. So, to tackle the, let's say, the fire topic, we also do have a different adhesive line, the so-called HPX, or now we are also launching HPX. For Europe, and that is an adhesive which we recommend to use for certain building projects, especially if there are some stricter requirements on fire-resistant properties. And maybe to answer that or to combine it with, of course, our main topic of today, the bio-based adhesive. So the HPXE, so the fire-performance adhesive for Europe, can also be produced as a bio-based adhesive. So it is then two in one, so to say. It's a fire performant and bio-based adhesive, which we could offer to the market.
Thank you, Olga. And again, we have confirmed that you were right, Olga, on the 100% shift, eco shift. But then he has another question, again for Henkel. No adaptation for us manufacturers regarding certification, no machinery. Is that correct? The logical follow-up question is the approximated difference. What is the approximated difference cost-wise? So it's the performance certification discussion question and also a cost discussion. Olga, this is for you.
Yes, right. So for the first question, this is correct. So there is absolutely no adaptation for the manufacturing needed. I mean, also no, let's say, flashes of the adhesive. You can mix even because, as I said in my part, so chemically, it is exactly the same identical product. So there is no change whatsoever needed to the equipment or to certification. The logical follow-up question, that is certainly applies. So the bio-based adhesive has a value in itself, and also due to the fact that the raw material base of the bio naphtha is higher in cost, so it's basically higher raw materials, of course, then also the product itself is a bit more expensive. But on the other hand, also the value added of the bio-based adhesive is also clear. I mean, by saving up to 10% of the finished good CO2. I think that is also something which is certainly worthwhile, or what is also justifies the additional cost. I'm not sure whether now the question comes of an exact number. That is, of course, depending on the quantity, depending on the application, so that I would rather not tell an exact, let's say, number on the cost side. But yes, it is some additional costing for the bio-based adhesive, which is required, again, due to the fact even that the raw material base is more expensive. But maybe that's also something, Markus, you could even comment from your end, probably also your customers are asking, so that might be, you might pay more, but then you, of course, you get more out of that.
Well, yes, when you talk about the price, you have to make a difference between the price of today and the price in the future. So the price for today for the bio-based glue is slightly higher than for the
conventional
glue. I have to look at Henkel, but this is the thing today. But our idea is that when we are taking back products in the future, I think the price will be higher for us if we have bio-based glue in it. So you have to take into account that the rest worth of the material will be higher at the end if you have a better glue today.
Yeah, thank you, Markus. And we actually even do believe that in the long term, I mean, now we are talking about several years, but at some point the fossil adhesive will be more expensive than to use the materials with the bio-based or circular feedstock. So that's actually, in the long run, we do believe that bio-based will be even more cheaper compared to the fossil products.
I can add to that with my meanwhile 9 years experience in the field of renewable carbon chemistry and that switch from fossil to renewable. So at the moment, the early pioneers get access to bio-based or renewable carbon-based oils and gases or materials, but there will be soon a gold rush to get access to these materials, because we don't have enough currently when the whole world is changing and the whole chemistry is changing. The good news is there are heavy investments in chemical recycling, pyrolysis oil, syn gas, and also in CO2 capturing and transformation. The technology is there. We can do that even today. We can start. And you are right. At a certain point of time, Olga, the fossil materials, we see that already today at Henkel. You see that in the reports. Since years, we have increasing raw material prices. This will only go up, and also the regulation piece will kick in. The world and EU is talking about carbon taxes, the CO2 taxes, and all that will also drive that change. When do we see that break even, that the renewable stuff is cheaper than the fossil? We don't know, but this will happen. The question is when to start. We decided to start, and hope others will follow to create also the market space for it. There are some further questions.
Maybe just one. I think, Adrian, you overlooked the question to Markus. It's a bit higher up, so maybe I can just also read it. So, Markus, a question to you. Do you offer LED, or equivalent certifications for your products? And the second question is, and does the use of a bio-based adhesive show advantages here?
Well, certifications like LEED or BREEAM or DGNB are always project-wise made by the building owner and their designers. But what they need from us as the material and the constructors in this case, they need, for example, EPDs. And this is what we are doing. We are making EPDs on each of our products, and we already were the first also who made circular EPD, which is already very necessary in the Netherlands, for example. And here, for sure, the bio-based adhesive has a positive impact, as Olga also showed in her presentation, in case of the carbon emissions. So at the end, you will have a positive impact on this with using the bio-based glue, sure.
Thank you. So maybe we proceed with
another question.
That is Olga. That's not a question. That's a comment. So that's a nice comment. Okay, well noted. Where do you see the main limits to greater acceptance for timber construction?
That's a nice one. Maybe Markus, you start first from your end.
Well, I see, or what we are seeing is that the building owners and investors, project developers, they like timber, they like wood, and they like ecological buildings. So they are not the limit. What they want is that they want a sustainable building. But when it comes to designing and to rules, regulations, the people who are involved in designing the project, like architects, engineers, they are often saying, oh, we have limits here with regulations, this is difficult. And so I think this is still limiting the use of timber buildings and high-rise timber buildings. We see differences between the countries. In the Netherlands, we are already building 15 or 16 stories at the moment in Rotterdam, and several kilometers to the east, to Germany, it's not possible because we have other fire rates than in the Netherlands, for example. So it's still a process here.
Maybe also just to comment on my side, I mean, of course, as an adhesive supplier, we certainly have a slight of different view, let's say, compared to our customers. But I think as Markus rightly mentioned, so I think in my views, there are three main factors which limits the acceptance or even further, let's say, acceptance of timber construction, although certainly it gets more and more over the even the last years where we see where we are coming from. And the future for sure is positive. So, but the first is certainly regulation, as Markus mentioned. So it's not necessarily always make it easier for the timber construction to do the buildings or to do the projects. Then it's the infrastructure. And here that could be everything coming from the know-how of engineers to all the other, let's say, craftsmanship which is needed to build and to design and to build then such a wood building or building out of wood. And last but not least, there is certainly also some cultural differences between the countries, between the regions where wood construction is more common, more accepted, and also more embraced. But I think overall, this is certainly why we are so much passionate about that. We do believe that it will accelerate even further in future, and there is certainly not too little resources, neither producers of engineered wood elements for the future to come.
Thank you, Olga. We are approaching the end of the session, so I would also like to thank you, Markus, again, Christina, for the help, and Olga, of course, also you. But before to close, Olga, please give some final words to the audience and final remarks.
Yeah, with pleasure. So maybe a little bit to sum up or to conclude. I hope we, or at least we try to make it a bit clear to you so that now you have the choice to use a bio-based adhesive and with that, taking sustainability in construction to the next level. And thank you all for attending today's webinar once again. Thank you, Markus, and also to the Derix Group, of course, for their valuable partnership and contributions. Just some organizational details. So we will also record this webinar and it will be available soon on the YouTube channel. We will, of course, distribute the link to you. Stay tuned for updates on upcoming trade shows and publications where we will share more about our ECO adhesive. Visit our homepage. And if you'd like to get in touch or keep the conversation going with us, you can reach out either to us within the Henkel or to Derek's team on the LinkedIn. And we are always eager to engage, of course, and to collaborate with you. Thank you once again for your time and participation, and have a great day. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.